Let us start structural isomerism. Structural isomerism is the isomerism which exists in two or more compounds. Again, having same molecular formula, but different in the structure. That means the arrangement of atoms within the same molecule. I repeat, molecules having same molecular formula, but what they are in differ means the arrangement of atoms is different within the molecule. Let us reach the definition on the two or more compounds having same molecular formula but different in structure. That means different arrangement of atoms within the same molecule. Chain isomerism. Here the definition I wrote on the board. Two or more compounds having same molecular formula but the different in the arrangement of carbon chain. Okay. So two or more molecules are different in the carbon chain. In what way they are different? How to understand the carbon, how to understand the chain isomerism, we'll take many examples. So here are the many examples for chain isomerism. Let us take the molecule having formula C4H10. C4H10 is a molecular formula. Then for this molecular formula, we can write two molecules, that is 1, 2, 3, 4 means buta. So therefore it is N-butane, or simply we can call it as butane. And whereas here is isobutane, or in another name 1, 2, 3 at second carbon methyl is there, so it is called as 2-methyl propane. So both the molecules having same number of carbon, same number of hydrogens, that is C4H10 is a molecular formula, but the chain is different. This molecule does not contain any branches, whereas this molecule having 3 carbons in a chain and 1 methyl branch at second carbon, but having same molecular formula. So we can take these two examples for chain isomers possessing the molecular formula C4H10. And we'll take another example having molecular formula C5H12. The formula C5H12 and the name of the compound is N-pentane. N-pentane means normal pentane which does not contain any branch. So according to IUPAC, is pentane. Then another name is isopentane. Isopentane. Okay, at second carbon methyl branch is there, so therefore we call it as iso. In the compound 5 carbons are there, therefore it is isopentane. And IUPAC name is 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons are in a chain, so it is known as butane. At second carbon methyl is there, so therefore it become 2-methyl butane. And one more example for same molecular formula is this is neopentane, because at second carbon in a chain at second carbon 2-methyl branches are there, therefore it is called as neo, and within the molecule 5 carbons are there, it is neopentane. And according to IUPAC, 1, 2, 3 carbons are in a chain, at second carbon 2-methyl branches are there, so therefore it is known as 2,2-dimethylpropane. So at second carbon 2-methyls are there, isn't it? So 2,2-dimethylpropane. So 3 molecules having same number of carbons, same number of hydrogens, but they are different in their chain. First molecule does not contain any branch, whereas second carbon 1-methyl branch at second carbon, so therefore it is known as iso. And third compound 2 methyl branches at second carbon, known as neo. So molecules having same molecular formula but showing difference in their chain, known as chain isomerism. Okay, let us take one more example having molecular formula C6H14. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 carbons are there, not having any branch. So therefore it is called as N-hexane. N-hexane or IUPAC is hexane. Then here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 carbons are there in chain, but at second carbon 1 methyl branch is there. It is called as iso, and total number of carbons in the compound is 6. So therefore it is isohexane. And according to IUPAC, second carbon 1 methyl is there. So therefore 2 methyl and in a chain 5 carbons are there. It is known as pentane. And in another example, again compound having 6 carbons, but at second carbon 2 methyl branches are there. It is called as neo, and total number of carbons in the compound is 6. So therefore it is called as N-hexane. And what is IUPAC name? At second carbon 2 methyls are there. So let us write 2,2 dimethyl. And in a chain 4 carbons are there. It is butane. So 2,2 dimethyl butane. And we can take another. So it does not contain any normal name. Let us write the IUPAC. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 carbons are in a chain. At second carbon methyl is there. Third carbon methyl is there. So therefore we can write 2,3 dimethyl. 2,3 dimethyl butane. Because in the chain 4 carbons are there. And here 1, 2, 3. At third carbon only 1 methyl branch is there. So therefore it is 3 methyl. In the chain 5 carbons are there. It is pentane. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 structural compounds are chain isomers. We can write for the formula C6H14. In a neat level, if a question is asked, a compound having 8 number of carbons, then how many chain isomers are possible? So here I gave example for only 4 carbons, 5 carbons and 6 carbons. If they ask more than 6, yeah, come to the note here. Alkane, when 4 number of carbons are there, C4H10, chain isomers are possible 2. And C5H12, chain isomers are 3. C6H14, chain isomers are 5. Just now we took examples. And if a compound containing C7H16, so it contains 9 isomers. C8H18, 18 isomers. C9, 35 isomers. C10, 75 isomers.
Liked watching this video? Like, comment, and subscribe.